this is Irina Slutsky reporting for Geek Entertainment Television on location in San Francisco in the apartment of Heklina, one of the best drag queens in...
One of the best.
Okay. I'm getting scared. Well, the best drag queen in San Francisco. We are here to record the transformation of this quite attractive male body into the very attractive... I guess female body is what you would call it, of
gender illusion
body of Heklina, very famous worldwide international. Today, obviously, we're talking to a drag geek. Heklina has been in drag around 1,500 times, we calculated. So that's 1,005.
Calculation.
What?
More? It feels like 15,000.
15,000. So Heklina's been doing Trannyshack for 12 and a half years. Her show has been licensed in London, Reykjavik, Iceland, which is where
New York.
Heklina's from Iceland, right, Hekl?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I
am. You know probably everything there is to know about drag.
Yes. Okay.
So I think a lot of straight men want to know, like,
how good I give head. How good the head I give is. Well, I'm gonna demonstrate right now. No, just kidding.
We'll save that for later. But really, I think a lot of people want to know, you know, obviously you dress up like a woman. So when are you going to, you know, get the operation? So tell us about, you know, that.
Well, that's another example of gender fluidity in the sense that I think people assume that since you dress up like a woman, that you want to be a woman, and that couldn't be further from the truth for me. I put on women's clothing, but I don't put on women's clothing that you could wear to the supermarket. I put on flashy, splashy drag clothes, and the only reason I put on women's clothing is to entertain and be on a stage.
So when I first moved to San Francisco, I saw some drag queens putting stuff on their eyebrows instead of shaving them, and this was very unusual. Tell me about this, Heklina.
Can't you see I'm busy?
Yes.
Okay. So for many, many years, I would shave my eyebrows off because covering up your eyebrows with this wax is never going to look as good in drag as having no eyebrows to be able to draw from. Anyway, I just got sick of it as a boy trying to go out and get action because I always looked like a burn victim or like I was always like had this shocked look on my face. So like I had to come up with an alternative. And there's a lovely makeup store here in San Francisco called Krylon. And this is actually scar effects wax. They use this in the movies to actually make scars, but it actually works really well to cover up hair also. And I put a layer of spirit gum on top of that, then a layer of foundation, then powder, and then I use it as a palette to give me more eyeshadow room. So it's a little drag queen trick.
What has drag taught you about sex?
I've learned that everything... It kind of in the gay culture is drag, whether you're a leather man or whether you're a drag queen or whether you're a Castro clone or whether you're a gym queen or a circuit queen, it's all drag. And they're very, it's very defined and very rigid. But other sexuality I've found is very fluid. Like I think I had a lot of very vanilla ideas about sex before I started doing drag. There was bisexuality and there was being gay and there was being straight and that was really it. But I've become very turned on lately to straight men and having sex with straight men in drag. And they are, I do believe, straight, but they want a chick with a dick. They want a woman with a little bit extra. And they don't necessarily want to sleep with a man. They want to sleep with a woman, but a woman with a penis. Probably after I do my gig tonight, I'm probably going to go to the Power Exchange and try and have sex with men who want to have sex with a chick with a dick.
Can we go with you?
Absolutely not.
So funny. Oh my God.
Isn't that erotic? Look at that.
Very erotic.
Bra action. Look at my hip pads.
Oh my God.
Isn't that fascinating?
You don't bother with a tuck.
I don't have to bother with a tuck because my penis is hidden beneath my underwear, my hip pads, two pairs of pantyhose, fishnets, and ladies' panties.
Oh, look at that. We're...
Now, this is the metamorphosis of the tit.
Oh.
Now, the tool of my trade.
San Francisco is a very particular type of drag queen. You don't try to go for looking like a real woman.
Well, I think that there are a lot of drag queens in San Francisco who do go for the realness. But the Tranny Shack kind of punk rock aesthetic is a little bit different. It's more about kind of trash drag and not so much about glamour.
Walking down the street and a man tries to get your business.
We've ruined the illusion.
You exposed all my secrets. Now you must die. Wow.